Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
All right, if you're hoping for rain, you better keep hoping. This is not going to be anything that's going to mess up your day all that much. It's been raining pretty good up in Washington, Oregon, Northern California, getting some showers, barely making it into the Bay Area and getting close to us right now with what is a very weak cold front at our latitude. Doppler radar last 12 hours, well, you see in blue, that's not much rain. Green is just barely getting into the okay department, good for a few sprinkles. There'll be a little bit more than this between now and sunup, but not a lot. And south of Salinas is not likely going to hold together. Most of what we're looking at is up in the clouds. 60s today, did a few of them in Scotts Valley, 63 in Santa Cruz. Overnight lows, upper 30s and 40s around Santa Cruz County, so not as cold as it could have been. Just enough low-level wind to keep it moving around there. 58 in Pacific Grove and in Monterey and in Marina, 62 in Carmel by the Sea and a 61 in Carmel Valley, and a couple of upper 30s there. Coolest Salinas Valley, but 35 in King City was the official temperature, but this you normally take it about 5 feet above the ground, so could have been a little nip of frost down there, but that not enough to cause a big problem. 64 in King City for a high, matching up with Gonzales. 62 Soledad and Salinas. 65 in Greenfield. And we had 66, the hot spot, such as it was, Gilroy, down to 39 this morning in Hollister. Elsewhere, 43 was all you could squeeze out of the day at Lake Tahoe. That's okay. We like it like that. 50 in Redding. 60s aplenty on Tigard in Southern California. Found a few 70s, but they didn't last long this time of year. 48 Boise, 45 in Seattle. Denver did make it to 60, but they won't tomorrow. 71 in Phoenix. And then under high pressure, pretty warm air going here, but it'll be the last time they see that. Still kind of cool. 54 in New York. Most of New England still dealing with some rain showers. Upper level low moving off the map. It's got a lot of cold wind coming around the top side of that. The weekend front that we had is now over the plain states, but just not a lot of moisture to draw from. They've been sitting under dry high pressure for most of the week, so they get a few showers, that's it. The rest is coming in with this low, and it's not really packing all that much of a punch. And by tomorrow, most of that moves in north and east of us as the trough swings through. High pressure builds in here. We got it coming up in the Great Lakes states to cap cold air. So this front is going to lose a lot of ground, and the other one moves out to sea. So it's going to be relatively quiet across the map. Over the next 5 days, our jet stream is going to be just kind of carving out that trough, sliding by. High pressure comes by, and the next one will keep that jets east of us, it looks like, but that also sets up a little bit of an offshore flow at the surface, even though it's a strong wind aloft. Not much with that front. Barely has any high clouds left with it, mostly low stuff. Next system way out to sea is between us and high pressure, so we're going to let this one slide by. Microcast says you'll be lucky to get any rain out of this guy pretty much between now and the sunrise, and that's it. And by this time tomorrow night, we're looking at more clear skies than clouds, so we're going to get this one done rather quickly. Overnight lows will be up a little bit from last night, only because we have an increase in the moisture levels, but mostly 40, still a cool start, but hey, you know, it's November. You got to factor that in. Highs will be in the 60s. That's not too bad. Low to mid-60s in Santa Clara and Salinas Valleys. Some clouds in the morning giving way to sunshine in the afternoon, and pretty much the same thing along the coast. Just a little bit cooler. Upper 50s to low 60s ought to do the trick there. A ditto across the bay. And figure Santa Cruz, Capitola, low 60s, upper 50s up in Boulder Creek and Ben Lomond. Along with that, increasing clouds. There's a chance of a little bit of light rain from about Monterey, Salinas, Hollister north. If you don't have it by sunrise, you ain't going to get it. Partly cloudy. We'll start the day, then we get to breezy sunshine by afternoon. And brisk little wind for an hour or two, and then it's done. Less breeze the next day, and then the winds will be very more north later in the week. So overnight lows will be a little bit cooler Wednesday and Thursday morning with some mid to upper 30s in the valleys, but likely not a lot of frost. And then we're going to be doing 40s and 50s as we head into the weekend, which accordingly will also bring warmer numbers, 60s and 70s. Offshore flow in town for this weekend.
Flow's so, coming
yep,
for a visit.
Yep, you can't get the rain. Woo-hoo. You may as well make it look good. So that's the option we've exercised. And have some nice weather around here. So tomorrow and beyond, car washes are okay, yeah. You know, all that kind of stuff.
Flo
you know,
loves a barbecue.
You got a barbecue if you want, you know, just remember it gets dark an hour early, but, you know, you can put out the tiki
maybe
lamps or whatever.
Early, yeah.
Yeah, you can do that.
Well, you know, it gets the kids bed early.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. So,
well, you always have an excuse if you overcook it. I didn't see. There you go.